want to introduce you to one of my Moran hens. She is a really good mama. She will roost on those eggs and not get up. She wants to hatch them so badly. She is so good and absolutely love her. They lay dark chocolate eggs, really, really nice. And I'm gonna let her get back to her business. There is a passage in Matthew 23 and verse 37. O Jerusalem, Jerusalem, thou that killest the prophets and stonest them that are sent to thee, how often I would gather thee children, even as a hen gathers her chicks under her wings, and ye would not. We see that tenderness that God has to his people. Absolutely amazing. When you look at the devotional today, you see that the devotionalist is trying to make it clear that there are times when God's people, they don't really understand the nature of God. And that's really what the Word of God and the Spirit of God is about, is to disclose who he is and what his nature is all about. And so with passages like this, and interesting enough, it's in a really rough patch as Jesus is talking to the nation of Israel about how they did not see him, and yet he is disclosing his heart's desire to draw them. Now, when it comes to God's people in the New Testament, looking forward to what's going to happen at the end, because he spoke a lot about this, and we seem to find ourselves there right now, so this is very relevant. He gave them some comfort, but he also told them that they were going to have to hold on, and I think that we need to really understand that while he told those in Thessalonica in his first letter that God did not appoint them to wrath, it did not say there wouldn't be a struggle. So this mama hen, she'd be sitting on some eggs. And so the idea is that as this incubates, and she's moving this thing around, there's going to be a day that that chick has got to struggle. And it's got to break its way out of the shell. And that is part of the process whereby that little chick becomes strong enough to make it in the world. And so our trials and our tribulations are almost like we're breaking out of ourselves that we can get the strength we need to really live in faith. I want to read the devotional text. It's here in Revelation 3:10 and 11. Because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world, to try them that dwell upon the earth. Behold, I come quickly. Hold that fast which thou hast, that no man take thy crown. What an encouragement, knowing that in the end, as things become much more difficult, we have the encouragement of the Word of God. I have noticed in life that people become better or they become bitter. And it's all about the choices that we make. And so let's understand the true nature of God. Let's understand what God really wants for us. Oh, Jerusalem, Jerusalem. He's desiring to gather us, that he might protect us under his wing, that he might nurture us and grow us into the people of God that he would have us to be. Not for wrath, but for strength. I hope you're strengthened in the Word of God. I hope you're finding time to be in the Word of God. Thank you so much for tuning in. May God richly bless you.